How will Minneapolis recruit more police officers? Police chief says the need is dire, but 2 weeks ago, the city council rejected the mayor's proposal, offering $15 million in bonuses. Today, the council met to discuss what they would like to see instead. Sharon Yu was at that meeting and joins us now with more. Hi, Sharon.
Hey, Chris. So this meeting comes after the council voted down the mayor's budget two Fridays ago, and the council has a lot of directions that they say that they want to take the money in.
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. There are 13 ayes.
Right off the bat, the city council members knew it was going to be a meeting that took more than just one sitting.
There are 48 amendments in the packet, and we will go through these proposed amendments one by one.
Of the amendments, the initial few focused on public safety, like Councilmember Elliot Payne's proposal to divert $3 million from human resources into non-police safety ambassadors in seven cultural corridors.
The safety ambassador program downtown, it's a really unique program because of the resources that exist downtown. I want to bring those kind of resources to more parts of the city. So the cultural districts have been designated as areas that have been historically disinvested in.
Specifically in his district are Lowry and Central.
We don't often have a lot of violent crime on Lowry and Central, but we have a lot of livability issues. We have a lot of people struggling with substance abuse disorder. And we have a lot of small businesses there that are just really wanting to have a safe and vibrant commercial corridor.
In another amendment, Councilmember Jason Chavez proposed reviving a community safety center somewhere where Third Precinct residents can go in the meantime.
Right now, when people have to file police reports, they have to go outside the Third Precinct. When people have to turn in lost items, they have to go outside the Third Precinct. We want to build this community safety center in the meantime, while the Third Precinct is getting built, and I want this to last forever in the years to come.
Having voted down the mayor's proposal, both council members say they're making better use of the money.
We're asking to be a part of the process. That's part of what we're doing today. These school services are happening because of that, and I think it's exciting. And that would have never happened if we would have approved the safety aid a couple weeks ago.
In a memo last night to council, the mayor outlined why he would be against certain amendments like one-time cutting funds from human resources to use for those cultural ambassadors in those commercial corridors. He says cutting funds from HR would lead to significant backlogs in hiring, especially with what he calls a team that's not only under-resourced but also overworked. But these are just two amendments out of 48 that need to be discussed. Meeting continues again tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. at City Council Chambers. Back to you.
Thank you, Sharon.